So today, we're playing a Reaper, and we are trying out the brand new Katana. We're not just using one, we're dual-wielding Katanas. But this build focuses on removing opponents' damage scaling, stripping away their buffs, and stacking up our Vampirism for a super anti-fun run. But hey, check it out, and let me know what you think of it. Okay, let's go and jump some games with the Reaper and see what we can do today. So today we're rocking the Relic Case, and I'm going to be looking to craft up a Katana build today, potentially. So first of all, we're going to be grabbing Wedgestone, we're going to be grabbing her sword. Goobert on sale for 3 is kind of a throw not to take. What I am going to do is going to grab the leather armor for this run. Even though this is on sale, I do want to keep our options right now with this setup. Because to position it, we would lose some value on our Wedgestone. However, we are going to begin a Reaper with a frying pan, wooden sword, and a wooden buckler with water stuff, which means we're going to be taking a little bit of spike damage. But this armor is going to be pretty good for a round one, given this. Just pausing the video here very quickly, just to ask you to subscribe. It really helps me out. Thanks. Now let's get back to the video. Pretty much triple our opponent's effective HP, which turned out to be super, super awesome. I'm going to go ahead straight away, craft up a torch. I'm actually going to ignore the blueberries. As much as I like to craft up a magic torch, I'm going to leave it for now. Now, I also really, really want to grab a leather bag. We probably should take this piggy bank. So I'm going to have to take it. And I'm going to slot our piggy bank in this position for now, giving us 4 max HP. Now, I really, really wanted to craft up a hero sword, but we'll have to settle for just an extra gold per round. I think that's going to be just as good as actually getting it. But hey, our opponent has also been super greedy with the piggy bank. We got kind of lucky faces at this point with just a wooden sword. They do have a leather boots, which means they do get 1 in power and a little bit of block. The wooden sword is going to be dealing a little bit of damage, but with one whetstone and a relic case, we should be able to deal more damage. Now, the problem is our stamina is going to be a little bit problematic since they do have that shield. But still, overall smashing. Now, at this point, this is a leaf badge. Should we actually take it? I'm really wanting to build up a Katana type build. But this could actually be leading into it. Because I do actually kind of want to go for Mr. Struggles builds, specifically for Misfortune, which does use that luck to gain 3 buffs. So I'm going to grab it, but I don't exactly want to roll looking for some ranged items. So I'm going to leave it in our backpack or in our chest for now as we roll. So all I want to do is find a whetstone. So I'm going to keep rolling for now. And I'm actually going to reserve the customer card, but I'm going to roll once more. And that's all we can really do, which is super unfortunate because we didn't actually find that whetstone. But hey, we're going to grab our stone. We're going to reserve a letter bag, and we're going to have to let go of the customer card. Now, the reason why I want the customer card is to actually find a freaking ripsaw blade. But unfortunately, it is what it is. Now, our opponent has one of the new amulets. Well, actually, there's only one new amulet. It's this one. And they also have the shepherd's crook. But hey, so far, it's not looking too bad for us. We are actually smashing pretty well. And awesome. Now, this new amulet is all about effect damage. You deal 10 effect damage and inflict 1 random debuff. And every time one is started, it activates, you have a 30% chance to deal 5 effect damage. Awesome, let's keep going for now. Now, we do have a choice to make, and we could end up just grabbing just stats. Super spacious is kind of awesome. We could also take shielded. But I don't exactly want to go for shielded right now. So honestly, I don't even want mana mastery. I just want to grab just stats, which is not exactly what I want. We'll have to take it for now anyway. And we got ourselves that whetstone, which is awesome. However, I'm going to craft a double torch instead. I'm still going to take the whetstone though. I'm going to sell our stone and I'm going to grab another piggy bank. And with that, I'm going to move on in this for now. As we craft up a torch. And we could craft up a hero sword, but I'm going to be keeping my whetstones available to craft up that katana. Because katana needs a ripsaw blade along with a whetstone. But so far, this is looking pretty good. Our opponent actually has this super awesome skill. Uniquely unique. And I definitely want to do some runs with that. But for now, this is looking pretty good in our favor. Awesome that they added in some general stats. Or some general skills. That's just stats. Which is actually pretty decent. Not crazy insane compared to the super hyper specific skills. But still pretty good overall. Now we're all out of all these, I'm going to roll, and we literally got that ripsaw blade, and we're going to say goodbye to a torch that we literally just crafted up. Let's actually add this in. We're going to be crafting up that katana. I'm going to roll once. I'm definitely going to want this stamina sack. But for now, I'm going to move on. Now, with our just stats, we do have 20% base stamina regen, which is awesome. But eventually, our stamina will actually deplete, so we might actually want to grab a banana for ourselves. Our opponent does have guard power, which is going to be quite scary. That is going to be a lot of regen and power. And now the Ripsaw Blade has been changed, and it doesn't actually take regen anymore. It has a different effect, which is still going to be pretty good. The effect on it right now is remove 1 damage gained in battle from all opponent's weapons and gain 0.5 damage. Which should mean whenever this gains +2 damage from the next attack, it should be able to remove it. Now, it doesn't actually get rid of the damage from empower by the looks of it, so that is something to be wary of too. But here we got a katana, which should be awesome. Now, this point, Goober did come back to us, which I do want to grab. But hey, this is our katana. On hits, remove 1 damage gained in battle from all opponent's weapons, and also gain 1 damage. If your opponent has at least 20 buffs, remove 2 of the type they have most of, which is going to be fantastic. But I'm going to grab this stamina sack for now. And I do actually want to grab Goober for this round. But I'm going to roll. Now, at this point, I'm going to stick up by one of our piggy banks, unfortunately. Actually, grab another stamina sack so we can actually place in our garlic. And if we're super worried about actually losing, we could probably have our leaf badge in this position to give a ton of value for our Goober. Or we could keep it in this position to try and get some crit chance. But it is going to be super, super low crit chance. So I might actually leave it this way for now. Now with a katana in, we should be in a much, much better spot. And I wonder, does it eliminate damage? It did actually look like that. Yeah, it gets rid of damage from the Shepherd's Crook, which is actually awesome. So basically, we're going to go for an anti-fun dual katana build. And so far, this is actually looking pretty good. Awesome, even. Katana is looking really, really strong. Well, at this point, it is a godly weapon. So it does make sense. But yeah, we could grab ourselves a card Goober, but I don't exactly want that. I do want to roll. We probably actually want to take this out because I don't exactly want any ranged items. Now that's perfect. This is exactly what I was looking for. And instead of crafting up a Vampire Gamer, we do want to craft up a Vampire Goober. But yeah, we might as well grab the customer card too since it is on sale for 2, and we're going to move straight on once again. Now, unfortunately, we did lose a little bit of value on our Goober because I do want to craft it up into that Vampire Goober, which should be pretty good. Our opponent is going to have a lot of damage with that Mold Spear, but we should be able to get rid of it, especially since that island is going to be scaling up that damage, and then we remove it with our katana. And actually, we're going to be taking their scaling damage, and we are literally going to be taking all their buffs. As it builds, I think the katana is going to have pretty good value in and smashing. So we definitely want to go Mr. Struggle here. Looking for Mrs. Fortune, and we literally found it, which is going to be awesome. Now we're also going to be grabbing this. I actually want the eye lamp too. Now I do actually want the eye lamp because I do want to get a bit of scaling damage on our katana a little bit more overall. Now I'm actually going to have Miss Fortune in this position. I'm also going to have Mr. Struggles target our leaf badge along with a katana. And with that, I'm going to move straight on. Now this should be a hell of a lot better. Our opponent is rocking Steel Goober's with this mini for dummies. But it's lucky they don't have that double axe, because once they have that double axe is going to be dealing crazy, crazy damage. However, any scaling that they do get, actually, no, they're consistently scaling up, and we're going to fall short because of that. So unfortunately, it did look like it was getting rid of some of the damage, but our opponent had so much scaling between the eye lamp, between the steel gourd and the axe, and we couldn't actually keep up with it, unfortunately. Which is a little less than ideal. Now we're going to grab our eye lamp. That's a second misfortune, which I'm going to grab for now. I'm going to sell this roll once. And that's a little luck if we do want it from the very beginning. It's also my Neku Neku on sale for 5, which might actually be a ton of value for us. Now at this point, I'm going to sell our torch. Take out our ranger badge as we roll. And roll again. And that's perfect. This is exactly the items I'm looking for. And that should be awesome. Now I'm still going to prioritize increasing the luck from our leaf badge. Now we could have it on a katana to try and get some crit chance. But we're going to be using up that luck straight away for misfortune. And we're going to be trying to scale up vampirism, but we could end up scaling up heats. And especially if our opponent is going to be removing it with a garlic. The increase in heat is actually not too bad either. But it does mean our Vampire Goober is not going to be doing anything really, to be quite honest. And unfortunately, we are still going to fall short. Which is less than ideal for sure. Now at this point, we did get some of the brand new skills, like Blood Manipulation or By the Holy Light. Which does give our holy items a chance to be on sale, and eye lamps and jinx lamps do become holy items, and they trigger 35% faster, which is awesome. However, I do really, really, really want to scale up Vampirism. So I'm going to take Blood Manipulation. We're also going to take Mrs. Struggles. We're also going to take this over. We're going to roll for now. We should take this out and keep rolling. That's perfect. Also, Toad is going to be super necessary. And we could end up grabbing a second Toad, or a second Island, but I don't exactly want to be stacking up Heat. But we're going to grab our Toad. We're going to place it in this position. And at this point, I'm going to sell our customer card. And with that, I'm going to move on. Now, we definitely want to grab as much Mrs. Struggles as possible. Because we want to be just removing all our buffs from our opponents, remove all scaling damage with our katanas, and just scale up a bunch of vampirism like crazy. Now, we may actually want to get rid of our eye lamp altogether because we're stacking up heat once again, which is not exactly what I want. But smashing. All I want to really do is find another source of vampirism. So we just start off with that. And okay, I just have to ask for it, and it literally shows up. Which is definitely crazy insane. We're going to be grabbing it. Let's also see what it's going to be. Damn the life, which is actually smashing. We're going to sell you, and we're going to take Mrs. Struggles also. Now, the problem is, I do want to add in Mrs. Struggles, but I also want to add in life. But I'm going to prioritize Mrs. Struggles for now. I'm going to be keeping a whetstone, because again, I do want to go for a second katana. But with the addition of our bloody amulet, we should be able to scale up our vampirism. Unless our opponent removes our vampirism. But so far, this is looking pretty good. Now, Blood Goobert should be going into overdrive, giving us tons and tons of healing, keeping us alive as we remove our opponent's buffs and remove their scaling damage. So basically an anti-fun build and just stealing all their life. And this is literally going to be insane, for sure. And that's a crazy amount of vampirism and smashing, actually. And we got ourselves Vampiric Armor. We're also going to be grabbing this too. And I'm going to grab another Misfortune. Now, it might actually be a bit overkill, to be quite honest. So I think we're not actually going to grab it. So I'm going to roll instead. Again, take out our Leaf Edge as we roll. We got ourselves Gin Slam, which, honestly, we're definitely going to have to grab. I'm also going to reserve the leather bag, but we're going to be taking Gin Slam for right now. The reason being is literally just going to be luck stacking, spike stacking the mana. We don't exactly need the mana or the spikes, but we're going to be using up so much luck that this is actually going to be able to keep up, or it's going to help supply our misfortunes. So we could potentially even add in more misfortunes now. However, we are going to begin another katana build with the anvil, which means they're going to be removing our buffs. They're going to be removing our scaling damage, which is going to be quite scary because we're super relying on that vampirism to keep us alive. However, their katana is definitely doing a lot more damage than ours thanks to the anvil. But with our setup right now, we should have tons and tons of healing. And this is actually looking not even close. Awesome even. Now, we did survive with 3 lives left. I want to see how much DPS we managed to get. Now, we have a very, very low DPS at 22, to be quite honest. As for heals, though, not so great because our opponent did limit our buffs a little bit. But it definitely could be better. The big source of our defense is literally just removing our opponent's scaling damage and just completely removing all their buffs. But hey, let's go and see if we can make this crazier. And I really, really, really want to grab a second katana. So again, I'm going to take this out. I'm not going to take any of these items. I'm just going to roll. I'm looking for two specific things. Mr. Struggles and a Ripsaw Blade. So I'm going to keep going for now. We could take a second Jin's Lamp, but I'm not actually interested in it. Okay, another Misfortune and a Toad also. That is hard to pass up. We're going to reserve it. We're going to put our Toad in this position. Now I'm going to waste one gold as we roll. And we're going to place this back. So we did change our setup around, so our Toads are targeting our Misfortune because these are going to be using up some buffs. And they're going to be giving us a ton of buffs, which is going to provide a lot more healing for us. But we'll see. With double Toads in, we should be able to get quite a bit of healing from our whole setup, providing even more luck, which should be awesome. Our opponent is also rocking a Ripsaw Blade, which is going to be doing something similar too. They've got tons and tons of block with that Stone Golem. And actually, we could be in big trouble because... No, wait, hold on a second. We're just removing all our buffs. And the fight's not even close anymore. We have a crazy, absurd amount of vampirism and smashing. Yeah, it was looking dicey to start, but we completely turned it around. And we're going to take it out. We're going to be buying our misfortune. We're going to roll. And I'm going to keep rolling for now. Okay, we'll actually grab a stamina sack since it is on sale. I'm going to keep going for now. All we need to do is find one more Ripsaw Blade, and unfortunately, we're not actually able to find it. So we'll see. Now, double axe is going to be quite scary. So can we actually stop it from scaling up? Because if you can stop the double axe from scaling up, this weapon literally becomes terrible. And it's still super low DPS. However, they do have a lot of pets, and they're going to be dealing quite a bit of damage. They're also going to have tons and tons of block, which we can't really deal too well with. And unfortunately, we do end up falling short. Yeah, without that second katana, we're in big, big trouble. We definitely, definitely need a second one. So I'm going to continue to roll. Let's grab this since it is on sale. I'm going to be feasting. We literally have no food items. Another Mrs. Fortune. Let's roll. Let's keep it going. I'm going to keep rolling. And there we go. That's smashing, actually. We're going to sell you. And I'm tempted to actually sell our Mrs. Struggle. Because I do want to craft it up this round. But honestly, Mrs. Struggles is going to be super... way too valuable to actually get rid of. So we're going to have to wait around, unfortunately, to actually craft it up. So we have a high potential to actually lose again. But we'll see. We are going to begin a Meg Clover Wincon. They're going to be trying to stack up 15 luck. And as long as we're able to remove a bunch of that luck and prevent them from getting to that 15 luck, we should be actually in a pretty good spot. And also, their Gingerbread Jerry is going to be using up a lot of their luck too, so they're actually counter... being a little bit counterproductive. However, in the trade-off, they're getting in power, they're getting max life, and they're getting a ton of regen, but we're getting rid of it all. And so far, this is actually looking smashing. That's a crazy amount of vampirism overall. And actually, this is a super long fight. That fatigue damage is kicking in, and we have a certain amount of vampirism right now. And smashing. Basically, we're just taking all our opponents' buffs and increased damage gains, and literally leaving them with nothing. Now, we do know our opponent literally has a Hero Sword and a Fortune's Hope, which are not super strong weapons. But they did have Gingerbread Jerry, and they did have the potential to get a Meg Clover Wincon. What's up? And we're going to be grabbing a Fanny Pack, we're also going to be grabbing a Ripsaw Blade, and we are going to be crafting this up straight away. Which means I'm going to have it slotted in like this for right now. And we're still going to have our Mr. Struggles targeting our Leaf Badge along with a Katana. And we could grab the deck of cards to get two luck from the very beginning. Which we'll actually grab. It does give us a Lover's card, which we might actually want to take, as this now actually increases our healing efficiency. So I'm going to grab it since it's on sale. I'm going to roll. We're actually just going to prioritize Mr. Struggles. And I definitely want that Stamina Sack. Now I know that we could be removing our opponent's buffs with this, but Mr. Struggles, just to be removing our opponent's buffs, like Turbo Crazy, and then we remove the damage that they do gain with the Katana, is just going to be way too good. More prioritizing just removing all our opponent's buffs completely rather than just being a 20. Now, actually, this is looking super, super scary. Our opponent's actually dealing quite a bit of damage to us. And unfortunately, we just couldn't keep up. Our stamina was pretty bad. And actually, I did make a huge mistake by not actually having our second weapon in a relic case. But yeah, we got our dual katanas. And again, I'm going to have to move this around because that was a huge mistake to be quite honest. But it should be much, much better right now. Now we're going to be taking our Mrs. Struggles. We're going to be placing this over. Like so. We're going to roll. Hall of Fire Lizard if we do want it. That's also an unidentified amulet. An unidentified amulet could potentially give us an amulet of energy. Which does mean we would just be turbo stacking luck. Although, that's another misfortune. Which we're actually going to have to take. I'm going to take out our deck of cards for misfortune. And we're just going to move straight on. No. Can dual katanas actually keep up? We should be able to get a lot more vampirism, a lot more healing. But the problem is, our stamina might not be as great. But we do have that just stats to help with our base stamina regen, even just a little bit. And so far, this is actually looking pretty good. Because if our opponent doesn't have any luck, they're not going to have crit chance, which means their katana is not going to be dealing as much damage. And so far, this is actually looking pretty good. The anti-fun dual katanas. It's not even going to be close. And smashing, actually. Overall, actually awesome, for sure. Now, we'll actually be grabbing a banana. I'm going to be rolling, looking for some storage. That's some crit chance if you do want it. But again, we're going to be using up a certain amount of luck. Now, we're going to be adding in our banana. We're going to be grabbing Mrs. Struggles. And I'm going to roll once. And this is it. This is going to be a final setup. I'm going to sell our deck of cards to roll one more time. And roll one more time. And that's that. This is going to be our final setup. A dual katana, Blood Gubbert, Mr. Struggles builds. With a bunch of just buff removal overall. While stacking up a bunch of Vampirism. And so far looking pretty good. Now I do think chin ups, he's going to be much, much better. So if you get the wolf badge, going for chin up instead of that katana, it's just absurdly crazy. But I do think that this could potentially be pretty good. But we'll have to see. We are going to begin our final opponent. And can we actually win out? Now we are going to begin a double X. We're going to be slowing this one down. And they do have a crazy amount of damage thanks to that anvil from the get-go. And once they get into that battle rage, they're going to be doing a lot of damage. Now they're not solely dependent on some buffs. But as long as we keep removing that heat, we should be in a pretty good spot. The problem is that double X is still going to be going turbo nuts. And once they enter battle rage, it's going to be going super, super fast. And we're actually stopping them from getting the invulnerability. And it's going to be super close, actually. And we barely scrape by. Holy moly. And this is an opponent that we would actually struggle pretty strongly against. Because they do have healing reduction. And they're also going to be less dependent on those buffs. So you think with dual katanas, our opponent wouldn't be able to scale up as much damage as it did with that double axe. So as you see here, our opponent did have a 59 DPS with that double axe. And then our katana hits for once. And it does drop down to 58 DPS. So it is a little... It's definitely removing some of that damage for sure. But the problem is, it seems like it's going to be super, super slow. And we did end up with a 35 DPS, which is not terribly bad. Definitely, definitely not great though. It definitely could be higher because our opponent literally had a 60 DPS. And then our healing was literally just about 26 overall. Which definitely should be higher, especially for scaling up Vampirism. But our opponent did have some healing reduction, which means our healing would be a little bit higher. Now our damage actually, because our opponent is the Berserker, they do have a little bit of damage reduction, so our damage would be a little bit higher overall, but still not a crazy amount more higher. But our defense comes from getting rid of a lot of buffs. And also, if you don't know, the Katana is all about removing damage gained in battle. But hey, I thought this was going to be a super fun build, being an anti-fun dual Katana build. But hey, if you do have any other ideas for Katana type builds, let me know down in the comments. But I'm going to leave you here for now. I just want to say thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like, comment, or even consider subscribing. And I hope to keep a lookout for the next one. See you next time.